Hi, in this video you will learn a useful animation that will help you tell a story. Let's say you want to convey to your audience that you had to pass through 4 process loops before you could get your project off the ground. Then this is the way you can visualize that story using animation. On a click, you will see what the first process loop is. Give your explanation, then on a click you can see that your project has passed through the first loop. To encounter loop number 2, you give your explanation. After passing through loop 2, you go to loop 3, and then on a click you can say that your project has completed all the process loops. Now it is ready to take off. Now the question is, how did I make this arrow pass through these circular loops? Now normally when you have these 3D circles and you have an arrow, when you try to make it move, you see that it either moves over all these circles, or if you want to send it back, you can see that it goes behind all these and it doesn't go through these loops. So how did I manage to send it through the loops? That is the trick that I want to share with you in this video. But before that, I am Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com, the creator of comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle, a collection of more than 4,500 premium animated PowerPoint templates that help you create beautiful and engaging presentations in minutes. Here I am on a new slide. First, let us create the 3D loop. Let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From Basic Shapes, let me select this one called as Circle Hollow. Let us draw a circle like so. You can always adjust the width by moving this yellow handle. Now let us apply 3D perspective to this. Let us right click, go to Format Shape, go to the Effects option, then go to 3D Rotation, and then choose the angle first. I'm going to choose this one called as Off Axis 1 Left under Parallel. Now to make it look like a 3D ring, let me go to 3D Format and add depth here. Let us add say 25 points depth. Now you can see that this looks like a proper ring. We need to adjust the angle a little bit. So once again, let us go to 3D Rotation. Here, let me play with the X rotation. When I click here, you can see that the angle can be adjusted. Let me click on Y rotation. Now you can see that it is straighter. Now to ensure that there are no lines here, let me go to Shape Outline and say No Outline. Now this looks really beautiful. At any point of time, if you want to have the angle changed a little bit, you can do so quite nicely. At the same time, if you want to have a different color for this rim here, you can do so either by going to Shape Outline and by changing the outline color, or you can go to 3D Format and you can always change the depth color. In this case, let us say I want to use this orange color. This is just for demonstration. So we've got our shape in place. Now let us draw the arrow. Let me go to Auto Shapes Gallery here and pick up the arrow tool, and let us say I have the arrow drawn here, and let us give this a different color so you can clearly differentiate this. Now when I move it, it goes either up. When I right click and send it to back, it goes behind. So to make sure that it goes through this, the first thing I'm going to do is to right click on this, copy, and then paste it back as picture. Let me right click and go to this option here called picture, which is the second option. Now this is a picture. Let us copy this by pressing Ctrl D, and let us keep the copy to one side. Let us go to this picture and then let us crop this so we have this cropped till the intersection of this point here. Can you see here? This is where I want to crop, and then let me click outside. We have the circle cropped in half. Let us go back to the copy that we made earlier and let us place this right above the previous one, and then we are going to crop from the other side. Let us go to crop and then let us move this, and you can see that it is the same point where I want to crop, and you can see that this portion is cropped out. When I click outside, we have this circle, but this is made of 2 pieces here, and that is where the trick really lies. Now we don't really want this anymore, so let me select this and delete, and let me place this somewhere over here. Now observe what happens when I have this arrow moved. At this point it goes behind because we have asked it to send to back. Let me right click and say bring to front, and then I want to have this piece brought forward. So I'm going to right click and say bring to front. Now the way in which the various elements are layered is, we have this right at the back. Then we have this in the center, then we have this piece right in the front. So when I move this arrow, you can see that this arrow moves through the circle, and that is where the magic happens. I did that for four of the loops. You can see that each of these is cropped circle, and all I did is use a simple motion path animation. So it stops at various points and then passes through each loop in succession. Now, to give you a quick peek of the various animations involved, you can see that these are the set of animations. We have this arrow fly in from left onto the scene, and right after that we have the text fade in. Then on the next click, this arrow moves from this point to this point, and right after that we have the next text element fade in. And then on a click, the arrow moves from this point to this point, and we have this text fade in, and the process continues. It is just a creative way of using PowerPoint. Let me show you some creative animation examples taken from our comprehensive all-in-one bundle. Here we show four-stage filter. You can see that on first stage we have these many elements, and then they get filtered to the next stage, and then further filtered down, and then only one comes out, and that is the four-stage filter. The next example is this, where we show five-stage funnel. This one has hand animation. On a click, we show the first stage and give our explanation. Then on a click, we have a hand that comes and draws the movement from the first stage to the next, and then to the next stage, and then to the next stage, and then to the final stage. This is a simple way to draw the viewer's attention to the point you're talking about. Another creative example of using PowerPoint animation is here, where we show that there is a lock and we have three options to open that lock. On a click, we show the first option. Here it is trying to open, it has not opened, and we say that this is the failed response. Then we try another one, it tries, and then you can see that it is still not worked. This is the second failed response. Then on a click, we have the final attempt. It tries to open, it opens, and we have the solution. And here we talk about the successful response. The last example is this one, where we talk about opportunity getting closed. This is the opportunity that is about to be closed. Then on a click, you can see that the opportunity is closed and we have a bolt. You can give the explanation here on this side. And if you want to have the opposite of it, you can do that as well. Here, opportunity is getting opened. This is the door that is bolted. On a click, we have the bolt open up and the door opens up and we have the opportunity revealed. There are tons of such creative animations available in comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. Please click on the link in the description box below the video, come to this page and check out more details about this product. It can be a game changer if you are a professional who needs to make presentations as part of your profession. In the meantime, do you want to learn some simple and creative PowerPoint ideas you can use in your next presentation? Then click on the link here to join our 5-day free email course called 25 Creative PowerPoint Ideas. These are simple, quick, and useful PowerPoint ideas I have not shared elsewhere. So go ahead, click on the link, join the course, and I will see you inside.